Wednesday night, April 11th, 2018. A couple of nights ago on our chat, I believe Victor brought up the subject of quote-unquote the Rabbi Abadi Birkat Mazon. And I believe Andrew had a copy of it handy, took a picture of it, sent it to the group, and I gave a thumbs down. And we got into a little discussion over there, which I didn't want to get into at the time. So let's look into the subject of a shortened or an abridged Birkat HaMazon. Let's see what Birkat HaMazon is all about, what needs to be there, what doesn't necessarily have to be there. I will preface and say that if you have the time, you should definitely not be looking to abridge it. The Birkat HaMazon, I personally say, I don't say Birkat HaMazon often, I don't eat bread often, but when I do, the Birkat HaMazon, I say, is definitely probably longer than what you guys are used to. I have all the additions. I'm not for shortening it. It's the only beracha we have that is mandated by the Torah. So take a couple of extra minutes and say it the way it should be said and give it, you know, full feeling and full wordage, you know, and praise where necessary. But I understand, sometimes you do eat bread and you're in a rush or you can't concentrate. And there's no point in making a beracha without the proper thought. So you need a shortened Birkat HaMazon. So we're going to look tonight at a book called Peqoudat al-Azar. Peqoudat al-Azar, 3-volume work. We're looking at volume 2. And this was written by Hakham Elazar BenTobo, or BenTobo, as some others refer to him. Some others refer to him simply as Rabbi Elazar HaLevi. Regardless, he was an important Hakham in the old city of Yerushalayim in the 1800s. He emigrated to Jerusalem from Morocco, and he was Abadi. Very, very important Hakham, very well respected in his day, and obviously until today, his Peqoudat al-Azar, I believe, has been reprinted, and it's been quoted over and over. So when he, basically this 3-volume Peqoudat al-Azar is like a commentary on Shulchan Aruch, on a lot of Ora Hayim of Shulchan Aruch. And we gets up to Siman Kof Pe Zayin, 187. He starts discussing, you know, this particular aspect of Birkat HaMazon. Sa'if Alef. Mipere, Shibirkat HaMazon, She'anu Nohagim Lebarech, He aruka kesat. Velef amim, bala adam be'emsa achilato is a sorech hechrehi, o onis, o dawar mizva, pegon hosaat hamet, vechnasat kalla, o l'muturala rabim, o l'pelelem asibur, pegon b'mosei shabash, is the menelot fillev asibur, kod b'kat mazon, b'se'oda shidishid v'chi yose, v'usrach tekef l'set l'chus. Since our current Birkat HaMazon is somewhat lengthy, and sometimes a person runs into a situation in the middle of his meal and something urgent comes up, or he has a situation like a mizvah he has to attend to, such as all of a sudden he has to attend to a deceased individual, or he has to deal with hakhnasat kalla, or he has to go, there's nobody to teach Torah, they need him to go teach, you know, Torah to, you know, to people. And it's the Sorech Rabbim, this is something he's doing for the multitudes. Or all of a sudden, he's Sawadash Lishit Mosei Shabbat, and he found out, oh, the minyan is starting right now, there's going to be a minyan, otherwise you're going to be stuck praying, you know, Be'ahid. So what does he do now? Okay, these are all different situations. So you see he has a little Aleph, a little footnote. You don't really see footnotes in these type of older books, but we have an Aleph. Let's see what it says on the bottom. مشكدة مران سمان كوف عين حيد بيبي ومران سمى كوف بيداد ومي عاد هكذا بري مران بيت يوسف بوزن سمان كوف عين حيد سيف أهل البيت عين شام بأورخ دي ألي باد خول عنما إنها دايم يخول السيد كل شبري بركات مزون دبار هرشوت فأفيلو هم ربين ويوسيم كلام أسور أفيلو عدار لحزول البري بركات مزون المفريع So let's say the same, we're going to go pray right now. So he's telling you, before you think, okay, let him say Birkat HaMazon after. He's telling you, no, we have halakha on the books that you cannot go and leave and go do something else and then come back and say Birkat HaMazon afterwards. That's what's giving you this little note on the bottom. V'harkach libarech al ma'a shirusim le'echol afilu haqe ehasur v'ata'am shemei yishkach melahazor u'shemei yishhe kol kach ashir akil. Because maybe he's going to forget and never come back. Maybe he's going to get, you know, involved and not have a chance to come back. Or maybe it's going to be longer than the normal 72-minute span. You know, by that time it's too late for him to say Birkat HaMazon, etc. V'lo uchel az lebarech Birkat HaMazon v'lo pelige poskim ela b'yosei dabar mizvah. The poskim shepasak maran b'shukhan rokevet esver alei dafil dabar mizvah asur la'akor mekomo ad she Birkat HaMazon. Elam ken, heniyah zaken ohole. The poskim shepasak maran kevetah yosei alei dabhachi afilu adam yahid or rabim chayosei mazim dabar mizvah mutalashin ba'orech. So bottom line, there is an opinion that you can leave if you leave at the table an older individual, or what do you call it, or you leave a hole over there, something like that, you know, and they're there, and you, because they're there, they're not getting up to leave by themselves, so you're guaranteed, your mind is constantly going to be on that individual that you left there, and you're going to come back for them. Since you're coming back for them, you're going to remember now that they're still sitting at the, you know, at the table where you ate. So you're going to say Birkat HaMazon when you come back. So in such cases, there are opinions that say you could do that. But even such, Maran is still against that opinion as well. And we generally try to tell people not to do such a thing. Now let's go back to the top. V'gam kama ba'alei melachot hatirudim me'od b'melachtam ve'en lahem penai afilu le'echol b'yishub hadda'at כי בחתו ואחות בעודם עוסקים במלאכתם ובגיען ברכת המזון אינם יכולים לבטא במלאכתם כל שיעור אורך ברכת המזון שלנו. ומפני זה הם צריכים ברמנן ברכת המזון
No.
Ben Menan, all the barik, we have Moskim and Echtav, we have Ruh Halil of Hassel Meshkatam Maran, or you are who believe Shum Kavana. Ben Menan works best over there.
Does it?
Yeah. Okay. They're stuck. They have to do this or that, and neither situation is good. We don't want Ben Menan means except for us.
Right.
Okay? That's what it technically means. Mm-hmm. So we don't want to be in such a situation. So Ben Menan works over here. So he's telling you over here, you have people busy at work, okay? They barely have a chance to eat normally, and I can attest to that, okay? If I eat, I'm eating standing up, I'm taking a bite, I'm getting back on the phone, take another bite, go down, help a customer. You can't eat normally, okay? So by the time it comes to you finished eating, there's no way you'll be able to sit and concentrate and say Birkat HaMazon. It's impossible, practically. ועודם עוסקים מלאכתם, הגיעים ברכת המזון, אינם יכולים לבטל מלאכתם, כל שעור אורך ברכת המזון שלנו, מפני זה הם צריכים. So what do they have to do? Or they have to make ברכת המזון while they're working, okay? And obviously they transgress a couple of הלכות while they're doing that. Or they make the ברכה without any כוונה, okay? אלה בנשימה אחת, and they just swallow it up, and they're done. They said ברכת המזון. Okay, no kavana, no habana, no understanding. And not separating between the words. Just, like we said, this is the only beracha that we have is the oraita. You have to be super careful with Birkat HaMazon. And you also have to hear every word of Birkat HaMazon. You can't just say it quietly. Technically, if you're sitting at a table, people, you have to say it out loud. Everybody has to hear you say it. You can't just be everybody singing there like this. Doesn't work. מה שעושים בשפתיו, כדי שלא יתאחר בה, וממילא עובר על מה שכתב מרן, סימן, קוף, פה, من بيت وخين هلخي درخيم شيوشبيم لإخول بيشيبا مماش وتكف داخل التام كميم أنشي الشيارة لديخ دركام وإن بريخ أدام بركات المزون شلانو وإن إن بني الشيارة ممتنين لو من بني أورخ بركات المزون هنا صريخ لكوم ولديخ إن بني الشيارة وبريخ كشهو مهلخ هفخ ماش كتب سمان قف بي جيمل سعيف تيت يعني okay so bottom line is in their day when people would go with caravans. Okay, you're going on a trip, you're on the caravan, and you're sitting down to eat, okay, and then all of a sudden the caravan says, okay, we'll leave it. You have to jump up, you have to get on, you have to, you know, now you have to be focused on that. So also, what do you do in such a situation? You're stuck because you're leaving the place where you said it, you left where you were sitting over there, now you're sitting, you know, on the camel, for example, and you're going, and that also you're transgressing different halachot. Because you're saying the lengthy Birkat HaMazon that we have. And it goes, and because of all of these reasons and the halachot involved, I saw that I had to create an abridged Birkat HaMazon that includes all the proper wording that must be in Birkat HaMazon. Okay, al pi halacha, he went and he surveyed all the halachic literature to see what words must be in Birkat HaMazon for whatever reasons, and he's going to explain all that. Goes, and I created an abridged Birkat HaMazon that any person can say if they need to, you know, without a problem. So that they tell you, oh, Rabbi Abadi made a short one. Well, okay, Rabbi Abadi may have made a short one. But we have a Hakham prior to Rabbi Abadi who also made a short one. Okay? And he is going to base himself as Rabbi Abadi's note on the bottom says, Rabbi Abadi's note, I believe, says, based upon Rambam. Okay? This is also based upon Rambam. And then we have Rambam. We're going to look at what Rambam has to say, too. Then we're going to look at the other abridged forms of Birkat HaMazon as well. Okay? So, the concept of an abridged Birkat HaMazon is not something new. It's not something that was meant to replace the regular Birkat HaMazon. It's a Birkat HaMazon that is there to be used if and when necessary. And that Birkat HaMazon also, you must still follow all the halachot. You must say it with concentration. You must say it with thought. You must say it out loud enough for you to hear the words. Okay, and if others are with you, they must hear the words as well. You must separate between each word. You cannot rush through it. So keep all that in mind. People think they could just swallow it all up. So, in Peqoudat al-Azar, he gave us the conditions and the reasons as to why he felt he had to create an abridged Birkat HaMazon. And now he goes to give us this Birkat HaMazon. And afterwards, he explains to us exactly the reason for each word in this version that he created, why it's there, what it's based upon. So what I would like to do, I would like to, if anybody has, Barry, you probably have it on your phone, you have the
picture?
The picture. Yeah. We're going to compare this version to your picture, and then we're going to look at other abridged versions before we get to the reasonings involved. Okay?
There were three.
No, this is the one version.
One.
Yeah, okay, good.
Okay.
So, I'll start reading. Okay. Anytime it's different, stop me and tell me the difference. Okay, and I don't think there's going to be that many differences, but there will be differences. So, Berakha Aleph. Baruch Ata Amonai, Elokeinu Melech Ha'olam. Hazan Et Ha'olam Kullo. Stop.
Oh, no. Keep going, I'm sorry.
Okay, no problem. Hazan et ha'olam kullo, BenTobo, Behen, Behesed, Ubrahamim, Umfarnes, Lakol, Umechin Mazon, Lechol Biriotav, Asher Bara, Baruch, Ata Amonai, Hazan, Takol. So word for word, exactly the same.
First
Beracha, we're good. Beracha number two. Nodeh Lecha, Amonai Lokin. Al Shinhalta La Abutin.
So it doesn't say Al.
Okay, so this says Shinhata without Al. Okay. Al Shinhata La Abutin. Eris, Hemda, Toba, Urhaba. Ve'al Shehosetanu.
That's not there. Oh, so it says Berit Vetorah.
We're not up to
them.
Well, over here is Ve'al Shehosetanu Meris Vesraim. Ve'natata Lanu Berit Vetorah. Ve'lehem Lisboa. Not there. So he's missing those factors. Ve'lehem Lisboa. Ala kol anahnu modim lecha ulach baruch ata amonai al ha'aretz ve'al ha'mazon.
Didn't say barachim shemach?
Nope.
That's here.
Okay. So we had a number of differences in this second beracha.
And the third, right?
This is maybe 1887 was printed. I can tell you exactly. Hold on. Tarnab. Tarnab means it was printed in 1892. But by that time, Hakham Elazar HaLevi BenTobo was already deceased. So he wrote it obviously beforehand. Okay? I would say closer to 1887, but I could check exactly when he passed away, and we know it was done before that. Give me one second. I would imagine so, yeah. He was very big. Elazar HaLevi BenTobo.
It's funny.
What's funny?
The other version that I have does not... is. Has more.
He passed away in 1886. Okay?
Right before the book was published. At least this one, anyway.
Well, good. With 1886? Good. Okay. All right. Third beracha. Rahim Adonai Eloheinu Al Yisrael Ammach Ve'al Yerushalayim Irach Ve'al Habayit Hagadol Ve'hakadosh.
Yeah, that's not there.
That's
not
there. Shinnikra. That doesn't surprise me that it's not there. Anyway. Shinnikra Shimcha Alev.
Yeah, not there either.
Umalchut Bet David. Is that there?
Yeah.
Umalchut Bet David Mishihecha, Tahzir, Limkomeha, Bimhira, Biyamenu. No, none of that's there.
Only David Meshichah, as far as I can tell, it's a Hamas.
Don't worry.
But anyways, in any case, all that other stuff's not there.
Not there. Okay. Machu B'David Mishihecha, Tahzir, Limkomeha, Bimhira, Biyamenu, Baruchata, Munai, Bune, Yerushalayim, Amen.
So the
Amen.
That's there.
Okay.
Fourth beracha,
final beracha. Baruch ata amonai keno medecha olam ha'el abinu malkenu hamelech hatob vehametib lakol hu hetib lanu hu metib lanu hu yetib lanu hu gemalanu הוא גומלנו, הוא יגמלנו לעד, חן, וחסד, ורחמים, בכל טוב.
Yeah, this one was a little bit different. It didn't say, it only said, הוא היטיב לנו, הוא מיטיב לנו, הוא ייטיב לנו. Sorry, no. It's in my head.
How about you just read it?
I know it's like, you know by heart, and you just can't get it out of your head. It says, הוא היטיב, הוא מיטיב, הוא ייטיב לנו. That's what it says.
So without the extra lanus, okay.
Yeah.
And did it have the gemalanus?
Yes, it has the gemalanus.
Without the who's until the end?
And then, yes, it has the who, gemalanu, gemalenu, gemalenu, instead of Rachamim, Mechol Tov.
Okay, now let me continue. Magdil Yishu'ot Malko, Ve'ose Hesedim Shiho, LeDavid Uzar'o Ad Olam, עושה שלום ברומיו, וברחמיו יעשה שלום עלינו, ועל כל עמו ישראל ואמרו אמן.
That whole bit's not there.
Okay, that whole bit's not there. And that's the end of it. Now, I know in that version on your phone, there is a second side of additions.
Yeah, here.
Right. There are no additions over here.
Hanukkah,
nothing. Shabbat. Nothing, no additions.
Yeah, anyways, there it is, that's right.
No additions, because Purim, Hanukkah, Shabbat, you're not in a rush generally. Okay. Right? Okay. So, we compared and contrasted these two versions. Now, before we open up Rambam, I want to open up Sidur Ahavat Zion. Many of us grew up knowing this Sidur. Okay? Printed in Yerushalayim by Eshkol Publishing. It was very common, especially here in the community. It was the Sidur that you would find in Yeshivat Magen David as well as Sha'ar Sion for many, many years. And there is an abridged Birkat HaMazon here. Yes.
I used the Sidur. I had to borrow one for the whole summer and I used it.
Yeah.
It reminded me of the Mansur one.
Yeah, it's pretty similar.
Yes.
So after Birkat HaMazon and after Ma'in Shalosh, then there is, on top of page 186, about half a page long, a bridge Birkat HaMazon. Okay?
All versions?
What?
All versions of the book?
Yeah. All versions of Ahavat Zion and Chibat Zion and Sha'ar Zion, because they made the same book with different titles. And this version over here is different. Watch. You know what? Better take a picture of this and send this to everybody because they're not going to be able to see this. Go ahead, take a picture of that. I'll show it to the video. Let him take his picture first. It's here.
On the right, yeah. It's the bottom one? No.
Top, this, right here.
Wow, that's very short. Okay.
Okay, see a video. So this version over here starts like this. And the instructions beforehand, Gam hanashim hayabu b'Birkat HaMazon. Women are also obligated b'Birkat HaMazon. V'lachen enan yecholot lebarech lechol hapachot yomeru b'Birkha zo. So if they cannot make the b'Birkha, they should at the very least say this b'Birkha. And it starts like this. Berich Rahamana Maran Malka De'alma. Mare De'hai Pita. Berich Rahamana De'zan Lecholla. So, opens up with a formula in Aramaic. It completely omits the first Beracha and uses just these. How many words are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 words in Aramaic to omit the first beracha. For the second beracha, Nodei lecha, Amonai Elokeinu, Al shenahat l'abotenu, Eres hamda, Toba, Urhaba, Beri v'tora, Lechem l'soba, Baruch ata Amonai, Ala arz v'al mazon. For the third, Rahim Amonai Elokeinu, Alinu, V'ali Yisrael, Ammach, V'ali Yerushalayim, Irach, V'al Malchut ben David, Mishihach, and then he includes all the extras that may be said for Shabbat, Rosh Chodesh, Rosh Shana, Hol HaMoed, Pesach, Shavuot, Sukkot, Shemini Aser, etc. And then he continues, Ubnei Yerushalayim, Ir HaKodesh, B'mehera B'yamein, Baruch Ata Amonai, Bonei Yerushalayim, Amen. And fourth Baracha, Baruch Ata Amonai, Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, Ha'el, Abinu, Malkinu, HaMelech HaTov, HaMeti, Lakol, Hu Hetib, Hu Metib, Hu Yetib Lanu. Who gave us, 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 Here we have an older Sidur. Sidur Aulat Tamid, printed in Livorno in 1937. And just have to take this one out because it was just easier to take out. This one, after Birkat HaMazon, has what they call an abridged Birkat HaMazon, but it's called Birkat HaMazon L'Ne'arim, children's Birkat HaMazon. Okay? Listen to this one. Nice writing. What?
Nice writing.
Beautiful writing. Livorno print is always beautiful. Here. See, beautiful Livorno print.
Very nice. Yeah, very nice.
Yeah, if you like that.
Take it.
It starts
at the bottom.
This is Barry being a photographer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's just... Hello, my friends. Kodak. So the version over here, and this is a little bit different. Baruch ata amonai elokeinu melech ha'olam hazan et ha'olam kullo ve'echin lechol biryotav ma'achalo ve'shulhano aruch lakol. Baruch ata amonai hazan et ha'kol. That was beracha number one. Different than the all three versions so far. Second beracha, nodeh le'el go'alenu אשר לא חיסר כלום ממאכלנו, ונתן לנו בריד ותורה חיי ומזון, ברוך אתה אמוני על הארץ ועל המזון. Also different. Third ברכה, רחם על עם עני ואביון, הנתונים בלעג ובזיון, עם רמוסי רגליים, ברוך אתה אמוני, בונה ברחמיו בניין ירושלים, אמן. And then finally, בחיי יהודה ואפרים, תיבנה עיר סיון ותיקון העבודה בירושלים, ותיפן עדינו ברחמים, אמן.
Completely different.
This is only three ברכות.
Amazing. But this is for kids, he said.
How about that?
Right?
It is. How's it possible? That's what they did. It's for kids, three ברכות. And doesn't only appear in this Sidur. Well, if they printed it and they kept reprinting it, so obviously it was something that was, you know,
they educated the kids,
at least at some age.
Right.
You have to teach kids something. Before we continue, let's look at Ben Ish Hai for a moment. Okay? Here you go, Barry. You wanted a picture.
the YouTube picture.
So, Ben Ish Hai.
We were saying the other one that only had three berachot.
That little one that we read you.
That's
for kids.
That's what?
What we have, three.
Why?
How many do we have?
Four.
Azan Rahman Abtabo, right? Allah is Allah's one.
Right. Right. Mm-hmm. And?
Yeah, it begins at Beracha, doesn't finish. It doesn't
it ends. It ends at Tob.
Okay.
The Haman is extra afterwards.
Okay.
Ben Ish Hai. In Parasha, in Shana Rishona, as we know, Ben Ish Hai is 2 years. Shana Rishona, first year, Parashat Hukat. Halacha Yod Aleph. He writes, נשים חייבות בברכת המזון, והן בעוון עתה, רבות בנות אוכלות בלא ברכה, מחמת חסרון ידיעה. Women also obligated to ברכת המזון, but unfortunately nowadays, many of them eat and they don't make ברכת המזון because they just don't know. ועתידות הן ואביהן ובעליהן ליתן את הדין. And in the future, they're going to have to give, be judged for it. Them and their fathers and their husbands, they're all going to be judged because they didn't say Birkat HaMazon. וראוי לכל אדם ללמד את ביתו בנעוריה בית אביה נוסח ברכת הנהני וברכת המזון. And every father should teach his daughters when they're young the ברכות. Okay? All the ברכות that they need to know, including Birkat HaMazon. lefahad nosah hakaser hakatub haSefarim. At the very least, the abridged version that appears in the books. Okay. Ve'im lo lamda bebet abiha haya ba'ala lamida. And if a father didn't teach her, when she gets married, her husband must teach her. Ve'chad niskar kol ze behesed alafim. Ve'ana abda, and me. Okay, I, your servant. Words would be Yosef Hayim referring to himself. Poor Irenu, Yechid Adeya Eduhim, in our city, Hid Pasti Nosa Hakaser Shel Birkat Amazon. I printed an abridged version of Birkat Amazon. Shebo Mazkirin Me'ain Hame'ura Beshabba Ve'yom Tov Ve'rosh Chodesh L'Halleko L'Nashim Be'Hinnam. I printed it and includes mention of Shabbat and Rosh Chodesh and what have you. Okay, and I made it to give it out to the woman for free. Okay, he printed it from his own money to give it out. Verabot banot ba'ot v'lokhot nosach zeh hanitpas mibeitenu. Okay, and many women come to our home to get this version that we made. Ve'gam im nosach haniskar hitpasti nosach kaser biyoter. And including, not only did I print a short version, a abridged version, I printed a super abridged version. Le'otam hem mit'assirim biyoter. Those people who are super lazy. Ve'en yod'im l'lmod ashurit. And they don't even know how to learn what the Hebrew letters look like. Dilfahot yomru zeh b'mkom b'kat amazon. Ve'hu. And it's a super abridged version. And let me tell you what it is. Okay? It's those 12 words that we read before in Aramaic. Berich, Rahamana, Maran, Malka, De Alma, Mare, De Hai, Pita, Berich, Rahamana, De Zan, De Chola. Veno Sakase, Zay Cholila, Medoba, Alpe, Ahar, Hirgilambo. And 12 words, teach it to them, they can learn it by heart, and they're done. Okay? So,
that's super abridged.
Super abridged. So, short Birkat Amazons existed before. They weren't created by Rabbi Abadi. They existed, and only for a necessity, not because this replaces Birkat HaMazon, like unfortunately people want to do. I don't think that was Rabbi Abadi's intention, but I think people took it to be that this is, you know, this is it.
When was there a push for that?
Push for what?
The Rabbi Abadi's, when did he put it out?
Yeah. You never heard of it before, David?
No.
You ever heard of a bridge of Birkat HaMazon?
Yeah.
Where?
I've seen it in Timothy Reek, but I wasn't familiar with his version of it.
Okay. Well, Rambam, we're going to look at as we read and want to see what Rambam says.
By the way, how did you, on a total aside, how did you know that this Rabbi Tubu?
Elazar ben Tubu.
Yeah, how did you know that he even wrote about this?
Because I've read the book.
Oh, okay.
Where did Joey get the book from?
That's how? Yeah, but
I bought it.
But it's like obscure, and it's like, okay.
It's not obscure at all, though. Peqoudat Elazar is not an obscure book. It's hard to find it, and as far as I know, it was reprinted, not a good printing, but it was definitely reprinted to some degree. But
it's hard to reprint. It's already like that looks. Like is very hard.
It's very, no, because that's a, whoever did that scan online did a poor scan.
Oh, the online
scan? Yeah.
Very,
yeah, it was a very poor scan. Because if you look at this, this is very clear.
Yeah.
All right, let's start now. First thing I want to read, the first footnote that he has over here on this page. You see with the, you see at the top of the page, you put a little bit before Beracha Aleph. Mm-hmm. And that brings us to that footnote on the bottom. And he wants us to know this before we even read any of what we read. V'sarich leba'ir she'lo tikkanti nosach zeh ela la'et ha'dohak. Obviously, Shem Shamayim. Ma'a ta'amim ha'niskinim la'il. Should I keep reading? I'm stopping for a reason, Dave. Come on. Because I want it to be crystal clear that I only created this version for extenuating circumstances. not to replace Birkat HaMazon, not to be said on as a regular basis, only if you're in a situation as I mentioned above. And you should not be using this version if you're not in a situation that I mentioned above or something similar. Shahare kawa nahagu abutin uve abut abutin ulibarech nosah Birkat HaMazon haaroch shelanu umidbael befi sefarim shu nosah kama maharishonim alayhim ashalom. Because we already have a tradition from our forefathers that we say the long Birkat HaMazon. And this is well documented in the books, and that this is based upon a number of Rishonim. Share ita betosim ma'kof pezayin reshono. Yeah, ve'adoni abi harozal. Haya omer ki le'olam hasdo velo haya omer imanu ki hasadav heim im kol hay. Ve'chatab maran zag. That Maran Zag. No idea what Zag is. Never seen Zag before.
What is the next two?
Hmm?
The next
Mishra Table. That's the easy one. Zag. Might
probably
be a typo.
It's probably a
typo. It's probably. Parashat Akib, Masahim, Kavanot, Birkat HaMazon, Birkat Rishonash, Birkat HaMazon, Tomar, Kihu, Elzan, Fonesakol, U Pasuk Poteh, Yadehat, Kavan, U Pasuk Nutin, Hen Kobasat, Kavan, Akashan of Vikim, Menos of Birkat HaMazon, Harambam, Katuba, Kamur, Poteh, Yadeham, Zbekul Hirason, and he keeps going. Okay, so all this doesn't really apply to what we have to do right now. He starts getting into certain aspects as to why he chose to follow a certain path. We're going to see above. So let's go back to the top and we can come back to this. So now.
Well, it's funny that Harambam's, you know, his Birkat HaMazon is the bridge, quote unquote. Like why the Mishneh Torah,
but
sure at the time, the longer one already came out. It's more from the Geonim, no?
Right, but Harambam's Birkat HaMazon is longer than all these abridged versions we looked at so far tonight.
Yes, I noticed that.
Okay?
Yeah.
But everybody says, oh, it's a Rambam, Rambam.
A couple of words, though. It's not much longer.
I'm going to open it.
It's longer. All the people that swear by the Rabbi Abadi Birkat HaMazon, which says on the bottom, based upon Rambam, when I show them this, they're like, Okay?
Yeah.
Good. So let's just look at the first beracha, just for argument's sake, in Rambam over here. Baruch atah Amonai, Elokeinu Melech Ha'olam, Hazan at Ha'olam Kullo, Betob, Behen, Behesed, Ubrahamim, Betubo Hagadol, Lo Hasal Lanu, Val Yeheser Lanu, Le'olam Va'ed. כי הוזן ומפרנס לכל, כאמור פותח ידיך ומשביע על כל חי רצון, ומכין מזון לכל בריאותיו אשר ברא, ברוך אתה אמוני, הזן את הכל. It's longer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the next ברכה.
This
is one is based upon the כתבי יד of הרמב״ם. Okay? The next one, the נודה לך, is even longer, watch. Nodeh lach, rather. Amonai Eloheinu unbarachach malkeinu. Kin halta et abotenu eres hamda toba urhaba. Berid v'tora. ועל שהוצאתנו מארץ מצרים ופדיתנו מבית עבדים ועל תורתך שלמתנו ועל חוקי רצונך שהודעתנו על כולם אדוני אלוהינו אנו מודים לך ומברכים את שמך כאמור ואכלת ושבעת וברכת את אדוני אלוהיך על הארץ הטובה אשר נתן לך ברוך אתה אדוני על הארץ ועל המזון. Okay? Much longer.
The one I got from a wedding was almost exactly what you just read.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
Almost.
Well, I mean, like, there's a couple of letters.
Okay.
Like, instead of there, they...
Good.
I'm just saying.
Whatever, and it keeps going on and on and on.
Because this version doesn't have the poteach et yadecha part.
No.
Yeah.
He's going to deal with that now, okay? So let's see now. נוסף ברכה ראשונה, העתקתי אותו מסדר ברכת המזון של הרמב״ם. What do you all think of that? He's telling you the version of the first ברכה, I copied it from the ברכת המזון of הרמב״ם.
Either he had an adulterated version or we have one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a different verse. So let's try to see a simpler version of Harambam, not based upon all the beautiful texts that we have nowadays. Let's see how different it is. You ready? For an adulterated version of Harambam, which has been the most popular version for the last couple of hundred years at least, here it goes, and follow along in Peqoudat Elazar and stop me. Baruch ata Amonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam, Hazan et Ha'olam Kullo, Betubo, Behesed, I'm sorry, Betubo, Behen, Ubhesed, Ubrahamim, Umfarnes Lakol, Ka'amur, Poteach Yadecha, Umasbiya Lechol Hayrason, Umechin Mazon Lechol Beri Otav Ashebara, Baruch ata Amonai Hazan et Ha'kol. Obviously,
it's shorter than the original that you read.
Yeah. It's shorter than the original that I read, but it's still, but it's longer than what Peqoudat Elazar has.
Yeah.
So now let's see what Peqoudat Elazar has to say. Okay, no sabr chari shona haytakti oto misev katamazon shel harambam zichron lebracha hamisudar besof sefer ahava. Ella, but shaharambam zichron lebracha hosif zeh lashon umfarnes. לכל כאמור פותח ידיך ומסביע לכל חי רסון ומכין מזון לכל etc. So he tells us that Hanabam has extra words. Okay? עד כדי שלום. ואני דילגתי מילות כאמור פותח ידיך. I got rid of it. I skipped it. כיוון שאמירת פסוק זה אינו מעכב עליבה דחולי עלמה. Because the recitation of these words is not incumbent and does not change anything for us. Kemuban, Mashkata Maram Bit Yosef. If we read Maran and the Bit Yosef carefully, we'll understand. Okay, Zedashono, Kataba Kolbo, Yesh Omrim, She'en lo marba ka amur poteach yadecha, rak hotmim baruchata monai hazan etakol, bili shum pasuk. כי איך נביא פסוק שאמרו דוד דברי משה רבינו עליו בשלום על כדי שלו, ואין בטענה זו הכריח. עד כאן לשון מרן. הרי דסברת היש אומרים שהבלי הכל בו, עד רבה, לכתחילה אין לאומרה. Okay, because now this is based upon a yesh אומרים, in other words, some who say that the kol bo is bringing, and according to that opinion, this pasuk should not ever be included in Birkat HaMazon. So how can we, if there's opinions that say it should not be included at all, how can we go and say that it's incumbent upon us to include it? Yeah, exactly. So because of that, there's no reason that we have to include it, and therefore I saw fit to exclude it. And that's why I removed it over here in this abridged version. That's what the Hakham is telling us. אין אומרה. ומרן כתב עליו שאין בטענה הנזכרת הכריח למונעם מלאומרה. And nobody can have any qualms against a person who chooses not to say this pasuk in Birkat HaMazon. So if Maran said that, then obviously it's not necessary, and we can skip it, as he did.
So
bottom line is, I took Rambam's version, and I cut it based upon my understanding of Maran in the Beit Yosef, and I was able to abridge Harambam's abridged version, as you called it before, Mark, because people refer to the Rambam version as the abridged. Okay? That's Beracha number one. And he explained himself.
So, question, the Harambam version, is he saying it's an abridged version?
No.
This is his version.
This is Rambam's version.
Got it. Okay.
This is Rambam's version. Mark was saying before that... Yeah. Go, so you
said
see...
It in court.
Yeah, okay, so say it again, please.
I said, if there were longer versions at the time, like, why did Harambam shorten it? If he did, or that was his version possible.
Because
he wrote it, but it's also a lot of times he writes things in the Mishneh Torah, which this is the halacha, what needs to be in the Birkat HaMazon, these minimal things.
Mm-hmm. Well. We could do is we could look at Birkat HaMazon of the Geunim, and we could see where it's the same and where it's different. But we know, as a general rule, Harambam was at odds with the Geunim, especially when it comes to when it came to prayer. So it could be that, you know, he purposely did something different than them.
He was known to be at odds with them.
Yeah, when it came to prayer, for sure. Many ways. He didn't like all the additions that the Geonim added. He discusses it in his Tishu B'Av many times. He felt that they were adding things, their own creations, to the prayers. They were giving too much freedom to the Hazan to do whatever he wanted. He didn't like things like that. So if you open up, for example, you open up Mahzor Aram Soba, and you see all these extra things. And it's similar in a sense. It's not the same additions, but if you open up Sidur of Rabbeinu Sa'adia Gaon, you'll see all these different things. In the middle of a prayer, all of a sudden there's a piece of poetry. And you see a lot of that type of similar stuff in Mahzor Aram Soba. Harambam was not into that. Harambam cut all that stuff out. That's very, very common. If you open Mahzor Aram Soba, if you want to sit and pray with Mahzor Aram Soba on Shabbat morning, you'd be there for hours. Just praying, without taking out sefer, just praying. So it's much longer in that sense because they had all these extra piyutim. Now, did they say all these piyutim week after week? Was this just an arrangement where you could pick and choose what you know, the Hazan decided to add, you know, whatever he wanted to at the time. We have Ginizah documents that show us that the Hazanim composed different prayers, you know, throughout the year. And whenever they composed something and they wanted to include it, they just, in the midst of the prayer, they included, new compositions, original compositions that they would sing, that they would read, you know, and nobody had any way to follow along. They would just sit there and wait till he got to a piece that they were able to recognize again. Rambam wrote a Tishu B'Av against that as well. He didn't like that. So it is possible that Harambam's version is a rebuttal to the Gaonic versions. And it may not be. I don't know. What? Doesn't have a full Nosach. No, just gives you a framework. Okay, bit. Barry, picture time. Here you go.
You flip the page?
You're going to flip the page, yes. But you're going to take this picture.
Okay.
Okay. Nosach. Nosach beracha shiniya. Ha'itakti oto meseder berkat hamazon haqasar leharab morinu harab Naftali. I don't know who this Naftali he's referring to is. Okay, but he's saying that he copied this version, this shortened version of the second beracha from a Rabbi Naftali. Behaskamat harbe megidole Italia. Okay, and it had the approbation of many of the Hachamim of Italy. Vibio hamagin Abraham behabair heteb behashire kinesa gedola siman kof saddi bet hagahod bet Yosef ud bet. Illa shehosafti ani milot ala kol anah modim lach lesi ede hobat hodaa tahila vasof. Kemosh katav harambam perik bet melchot berachot halacha gimel. So you're saying, I took this abridged version that already had the seal of approval of the Hakamim of Italy, and it's mentioned in Magin Abraham, it's mentioned in the Ba'ir Hateb, mentioned in Shire Knesset Gedola, etc., etc. But I didn't take it as is, I added to it. What did I add? I added Al HaKol Anahnu Modim Lach. Okay? The only problem is, right, okay. So towards the end of the beracha, right before he gets to that closing of Baruch Atah Adonai Al Haaretz V'Hamazon, you'll see in the Hakham's version over here, he tells you, "V'natata lanu b'rivei Torah v'lechem l'sbo'ah, al hakol anachnu modim lach." And then he goes, he ends the beracha. And he says, I added that because, okay, you see it over here, kemosh k'tav, because Harambam writes in Hilchot Berachot Halacha Gimel that you have to have Hoda'ah, you have to have thanks at the beginning of the Beracha and at the end of the Beracha. And because of that, I felt that I needed to include it over here. So we open it with Nodeh Lecha, right, with thanking, and I close it with Anahnu Modim Lach, we're thanking. ורבינו הטור סימן קוף פה זיין זל, בי אבא אמר צריך שיזכיר בה הודעה תחילה וסוף. And the tour said the same thing. He's quoting his father the Rosh, and he's saying, my father also said that we have to have הודעה תחילה וסוף. We have to give thanks at the beginning and the end. וזה שאומרים בה ועל הכל אנו מודים לך וסיים הטור זל וכל מי או שלא הזכיר מה שחייבו החיים להזכיר לו יעשה ידי חובתו. So if you do not include the minimal things that the Hakamim have said that you have to do, then you do not fulfill your obligation. וביום מגן אברהם סעיף קטן בית השונו ואם לא אמר בה הודעה תחילה בסוף מחזירין אותו. Okay, כמו שכמעט אמר בטור, הקן השונו. Okay, and if you don't say, you have to go back. And you have to repeat it, in fact. V'ra'iti l'harab shiyure k'nesa gedola siman qof saddi bet shiibi mash kadav habayit hadash nosah bekat amazon qasir meha kolbo v'ekshi alav v'ahar kach hiibi nosah bekat amazon l'harab morin harab Naftali b'haskamat harbe megedola Italia v'lo hekshi alav kilum. וכן השירי כזכותה לא הקשה כלום על נוסח מורינו הרב נפתלי הנזכרת, ובין בנוסח הכל בו, ובין בנוסח הרב נפתלי, אין שם הודעה בסוף נראה לסביר עליה, למה שכתב רבינו הטור, או מי שלא הזכיר, לא כאה, אלא על בירי ותורה. He says, so we have this situation, and watch what he says over here, this is very interesting. It says that the Shiure Knesa Gedola, okay, right, you all love Rabbi Haim ben Ministi, okay, he brings what the Bayit Hadash mentions in a version of an abridged Birkat HaMazon from the Kolbo. So we're talking about something, we're talking about 1200s, okay? We're talking also the time of Harambam. Abridged Birkat HaMazons. And they questioned, in other words, they had problems with this abridged form of the Kolbo, And then they brought in this abridged version of Rabbeinu Naftali, and they didn't question it. And I don't understand why they didn't question it, because the same issue of lack of Hoda'ah, the end of Beracha, is in both the Kolbo's version and the Rabbeinu Naftali version. Because I don't understand how they can't bring it up. It could be because they mentioned B'riv Torah, you know, the Torah is like a Hoda'ah, so maybe that's why it's okay. Because I don't see it as being enough. I don't go for it either. And obviously, Chaim al-Azhar ben Tobo didn't go for it, and that's why he had to include it. He said, B'riv Torah, V'lechem l'sbo'a, ala kol anahnu imlach. We have to thank you. We're going to thank you for the B'rit. We're going to thank you for the Torah. We're going to thank you for the bread that you gave us to satiate us. We're thanking you for everything. And then, end of the Beracha, ala alif ala mazon. Okay. Veraiti laharam nar shalom shamsel siman kof chavzain siv kenan siv gimel im lo hiski kata megin Abraham v'im lo amar ba hoda tihila basov mahzirin oto moshe amar batur hakeshino v'hainu midakayil v'amar ki kol mish lo hiski ma shehiyibo hachemim midaski lo yasayidei havato al kanashino fi aniyot da'ati lo kata batur ken illa kalpe tebe gemara lo amru dela yasa illa bimi shelo ama b'ri v'tora berkata aris umalchu b'david b'bonei Yerushalayim aba bimi shelo hizkir hoda'a amrinan hareze mehunne illa deharosh kata b'shem b'ru hananel dechen b'chul lehu inlo amar lo yasa de havato ma'at kena tur b'imkin tur namikin kabateo aba mikum makum inze illa kishlo hizki hoda'a kilal dahi itab gemara b'chol ha'pichot ma'amun ha'skab m'gunne l'shon ha'rosh lo amar kol ikkar illa kol shlo hizki illa ha'ad m'kin la'il dela yasa de chivad b'gemara amrinan v'ha'poteyah v'ha'pohet alifhot ma'amun b'chol ha'poteyah v'ha'pohet ma'amun אלמאל הוזכרו, הודעה תחילה בסוף, אלא מזווה, אבל אמלה לפחו, ולאמר, הוא אפילו מגונה, לא אביה וכשלם, הנהר שלום. So he's saying that he's still sitting on this point of, let's say a person does not include הודעה. Must he really go back? Do we make him now repeat because he missed הודעה? He's telling you that was the opinion that we mentioned above because but I don't buy it. It seems that it's a mistake based upon the sources. If you open up in the Gemara and you open up in the Tur and you open up Beit Yosef, you open up all the sources, that doesn't exist over there. It's really only somebody who does not mention Berid V'Torah in the second Beracha and somebody who does not mention Malchut Beit David in the third Beracha. If you omit either one of those things, then you definitely have to go back. But omitting hoda'ah, omitting thanks in the second beracha, is just considered davar miguneh. It's a disgusting trait. Wow. Okay? And for that reason alone, it can't hurt to make sure that we add that extra hoda'ah, that extra thanks within that second beracha. But if you missed it, for whatever reason, you wouldn't have to go back and repeat it. Okay? So now, did we say that the other versions have Malchut Beit David in that third Beracha? I think we said it was it missing or no? Or maybe only when you call the... Maybe the Beit HaGadol HaKadosh was missing?
Yeah.
So he had what he called. He had the Malchut Beit David.
The Abadi version?
Malchut Beit David definitely was included.
Hmm?
The Abadi version?
Well, any of the other versions. Like this one for kids does not mention anything about Malchut Beit David.
Yeah, that's in the Rahim, right?
Yeah. Okay. So what I'm saying is the kids' version that we saw over here does not have anything about Malchut Beit David. Okay?
He's saying here that you would have to go back based on...
Yeah. You would have to repeat. Okay. This version that we read, the bridge version over here, has Malchut Beit David. Okay, and you said the Rabbi Abadi version has Malchut Beit David. And obviously, Peqoudat al-Azhar has Malchut Beit David. So they all, Malchut Beit David is a crucial factor. Same way, Berid V'Torah, okay, in the second Beracha is a crucial factor they all have B'rivei Torah, correct?
I think so.
I believe we read them all, in all of them.
Yeah, what are they missing?
B'rivei Torah was missing? Even the kids' version has B'rivei Torah. You have it over there?
Is it here? It's in the first?
No. Second one.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's there. Right. They all include it. So these crucial factors are all there. Okay. V'ayin. אבל במה שאומר תחילה בריא ותורה ואין אומר בסוף ועד בריא תחילה וכו' יוסי ידי חוותו אפילו הרמב״ם זל כיוון שאמר לשון נזכה בשז וכן נראה מסבר כת המזון של הרמב״ם זל שבתחילה אמר בריא תורה ובסוף לא חזר לומר אלא על תורתך של מתנו ועל חוקי סונה של ראתנו ואילו על בריא תחילה שחתם שרינו לא אמר נראה שהאמת כמו שכתב ומטעם זה לא הקשו הבית חדה בשביל נגשר על נוסף ברכת המזון של הכל בו ברכת המזון להרב מראה ונפתדי שלא הזכירו בהם אלא בני ותורה ולא עברי דרכה וכולי פני מה שכתב הבית חדש ברכת המזון של הכל בו הביאו השירי כנס הגדולה ועוד בלשון ברכה בית משמע מעיקר מטבע שלא אמר בה ארץ חמדה, טובה, הרחבה, ולא הזכיר בה יסף מצרים, ולא יסר בה ידי חובתו, ומקרון פס בווניסיה, ברכת המזון קסה להרב מהרב נפתלי, בהסכמת הרבה מגדולי איטליה, ולשונו. Okay, so bottom line, he's telling you, you have this issue of ברית ותורה. And you also have in our longer ברכת המזון, we say ברית ותורה, and we'll say ואבריתך, שחטאת בשרנו, ותורתך של מתנו, וחוקי סונה של ראתנו, ונחיים בזרות שאתה זוהר נפונס אותנו. He said all these things. So now, do you have to say, ברית ותורה, and you also have to say, ואבריתך שחטאת בשרנו, ותורתך של מתנו. Must you say, mention ברית and תורה in two places within this ברכה. And if so, if it's incumbent, then we have to include it in this short version as well. So that's what he goes on to discuss over here. And he points out that if you look at Maran, Maran seems to be saying that once is sufficient. But if you look at Harambam, Harambam has a problem if you only say it once in the end and you don't say it in the beginning. In other words, if you only say, and you don't say, Berit by itself. So it's more important to say Berit than saying Ve'al Berit Decha Shatam Sarenu, because if you look at Harambam's version, he says Berit Betorah, and then he doesn't say Ve'al Berit Decha Shatam Sarenu. Because based upon that, we can deduce that the first one is the important one, and the second one is not as important. Because look what he says over here, Harambam, very carefully. He starts, Is Hamda Tobar Haba. Then he goes, Berit Vitora. Okay? And then he keeps going on. And then he ends, and then he comes back over here at the end. Where'd it go? Okay. I'm sorry. Berit Vitora. Ve'al Shehosetan Menes Yisraim. He took us out of Egypt. Uvditan Vit Abadim. Okay? And you redeemed us from the house of slavery. Ve'al Torah Techa Shlim Matanu. He mentions Torah, but no Berit over there. He doesn't mention berit ever again. So you must say berit in the beginning, and that's more important than mentioning berit later on. So once you mention the clause of berit v'torah in the beginning, you could omit, and since Haramam doesn't mention berit later on, you could omit the berit and the Torah and everything else later on, as long as you have it in the beginning. That's what he was able to do over here from this issue in Maran and the Sharia Knesset HaGedola and in Harambam. And so that's why he put it over here. Because we have to understand what are the fundamental factors in Birkat HaMazon. If you have to skip. Now let's say you have to skip and you only have a regular Sidur. If you don't remember all these points, if we don't study the points, you're not going to know what to skip. You know? So this is important because you say, I'll just have the short one, it's there. But sometimes you need to know what you can do away with and for what reason. Now, in passing, he mentioned that this abridged version of this Rabbi Naftali, I'd love to know who he is, we'll have to find out. Okay, it was actually published in Venice, and it was all the rage at the time. Okay?
That means they were using it.
They were using it, but at what time period, and who was this Rabbi Naftali? You know? Birkat HaMazon HaQasar, Laharab Morir Harab Naftali, Bhaskamat Harbem Megidulei Italia. And it had the approbation of many of the great Hakhamim of Italy. But this would have to be done early on, probably around 1600 or so. Okay, and nobody was able to come up with a hayyub, or nobody, not nobody, but rather the Bayit Hadash wasn't able to come up with an obligation to mention Yisya Mislaim in this Biracha. V'chem benosah harab, morin harab naftali, more on the next page, but we'll take a picture of that in a minute. Lo hiskira, and also Rabbi Naftali didn't mention Yisya Mislaim. Al kol ze keven shera'iti, shabayit hadash makpid ala kol bo shelo hiskira. But since I saw that the Bayit Hadash was troubled that the Kolbo did not mention it, if Al Pi Shehu Asmo Hebi Aharkach Nosa Marab Naftali Beskat Kamar Benim Velo Hazar Laakshot Alehim, and even though the version of Rabbi Naftali doesn't have it, and nobody questions that, Ma'alinyani Sam Islam Kenir Eshi Ikara Kabadato Al Nosa Hakolbo Hum Penishilo Amar Eres Hamda Toba or Haba. Okay, but he questioned the issue of Eres Hamda Tobar Haba. And Eres Hamda Tobar Haba, we're talking about the beauty of the land that we are coming to. But if you're talking about the land you're coming to, you have to mention the land that you're leaving also, as well. So you have to mention Mislaim in that case. Begam lo hiskir se Mislaim, abad im hiskir Eres Hamda, sagesh bichlada hu yisei Mislaim shan hata Israel, while shan halat. So now we have Hosetanum Mislaim, and we've based upon Eres Hamda Tobar Haba. So the other versions have both. Do all the other versions mention Eres Hamda Toba or Haba and Ve'al Shehosetanum Eres Mislaim? I believe the Rabbi Abadi version didn't have. I'll show Satan and Mirus Rasulayim. But Harambam also breaks it apart. Harambam also breaks it apart. It says, Eres Hamda Tobar Haba, Biri Vitora, Ve'al Shehu Satan and Mirus Rasulayim. Okay, so